Right, let's get inside. Hi, and welcome back to, this will be episode 4 on the restoration and conversion of this lovely old barn. Before we get started on today's job, on the next couple of days' job really, I thought I'd take you on a quick tour of how things are looking generally around the barn. So let's go take a look. So, yes, all the plasterboarding is done. The ceiling is all foamed up and taped. So is the flue for the wood burning stove. We've got the steels all boxed in. Beading around all the openings and all the corners. Got the beading up this post and the picture recesses formed. That wall has been left open for the time being. Sorry about all the stuff in front of it. I mean this wall here. I'm gonna do something, I hope, fairly interesting there. Door lining, saw in the last video. Bathroom is, I'm afraid, just storage at the moment. It'll be a little while before I get onto the fit out there. But this room's looking really nice. Ceiling's all ready for plaster. Steel's boxed in above the doors there. And then we've got this wall all boarded up, ready for plastering as well. There's actually going to be a wardrobe fitted in there. The reveals have all got to be rendered, so there's a little bit of stonework there that'll actually get covered up ultimately. We'll have the same there, that reveal there will be rendered in that same sort of lime coloured render that you can see there. Haven't shown you the fitting of these windows yet, or this window I should say. I will do as and when I fit this window here, and it's obviously got to be knocked through, and this one here. Right, there's a loft area up there. I need to form a wall up there, but that wall needs to provide access to all of that equipment for maintenance and repairs as necessary. So that's what I'm going to get started on now. I'll form some stud work up there, and then clad it in ply and plasterboard as required. And it'll all make sense as I get into it. Let's go. Thank you. Right, next job is going to be to get a line marked out all the way along there and up the ceiling where I want this stud work to be located. So I've got to get that box out of the way, set the laser level up, and yeah, make a few marks. So that's closed off under the purlin over there. That's going to be permanently closed up. Don't really need to get to that. There's going to be a sort of mezzanine ceiling there, which will be for storage or just decoration. And there's the stud work complete. The next step is to cut and install some plasterboard and then cut the sections of ply which are going to form the hatches. I'm not going to film a great deal of that because it's nothing you haven't seen before, so I'll just show you what it looks like when it's done.